Hello and welcome to The Cricket Digest. The IPL is celebrated like a festival in India, with cricket fans being hooked to their TVs for 4 hours every night for nearly 2 months. The confirmation of the IPL has come as a welcome news for the fans and players alike. The tough times that the world has gone through in the past 6 months have dampened the spirits of everyone. Being stuck at home with nothing to do has not only taken a toll on our physical health, but also on our mental health. This effect is even more pronounced on the players because they are used to traveling the world, living in a team environment and indulging with fans. Indian players will leave for UAE by the end of August for the IPL. There, they will stay quarantined for a week before they can start training. Even after the quarantine is over, they will have to stay within the bio bubble that will be created to ensure safety against the coronavirus. Staying inside the bio bubble means the players will not be allowed to go anywhere outside. They'll be training, playing, and staying inside the hotel room. And this routine will go on till the IPL final, which is scheduled to be played on November 10th. The bio bubble doesn't end here. Right after the IPL, Indian team is expected to travel to Australia, where the bilateral series is scheduled to begin from December 3rd. With the strict quarantine regulations that the Australian government has imposed upon all arrivals, the Indian squad will have to stay in a 14-day quarantine upon arriving in Australia. And after that, the bio bubble will continue. The Indian team will come back to India by the end of January next year. This means most of the Indian cricketers will be away from home and will be living in a bio bubble environment for almost 5 months. Staying away from home and living inside a bio bubble for such a long period will not be easy for anyone in the squad. In the just concluded England-West Indies series, we saw how difficult it had become for the West Indies team by the end of the tour. They lost the final test without even putting up a fight. Players like Jason Holder and Roston Chase even admitted that the team were feeling homesick and how being stuck in the bio bubble for such a long time had completely drained them. Having created history in the last Indian tour of Australia by being the first Asian team to win a test series in Australia, the expectations from this Indian team are very high. These expectations may also put an undue burden on the players and their mental health may take a severe toll. A few players in the past, like Abhinav Mukund, Robin Athappa and Kiran More, have opened up about the mental health problems they faced during and after their playing days. Hope the BCCI will come up with some program to tackle mental health issues of the players. What do you guys think about it? Do let us know in the comment section. Until next video, goodbye.